Welcome back. The tunnel led into this large chamber containing a big cylinder with the dummy number one on it. We can hear the hum of power, so I guess this is being powered by these cables that run back to the water wheel. But what purpose does it serve? That's a good question. Let's look at this. We have a whole bunch of things. And look like you can move that. Let's see what else there is before we continue with that. Dummy number two. Seems to be the same story. Wait, are those connected? I wonder. That one. Did that also move this one? Or are they all independent? No, yeah, yes, this one did move. So, they're connected. Okay, interesting. And on this side, dummy number three, and more of the same. And more pages as well. It's taking me too long. Every minute I spend searching his house runs a risk of someone walking in and finding me. I would bring his journals to the Tusk, but I'm afraid he will notice them gone. Already I'm afraid of what he knows. What his wife might know. She almost caught me last time. I'd linked directly into the sunroom. I was walking toward his study when I heard footsteps coming down the hall. She was talking with someone. She was laughing, and for one heart-wrenching moment, I thought she was Tamara. Then I remembered my Tamara's dead. I left her to die when I went after the brothers. I told her to go to the reef, to take our two girls there and hide. I took the necklace she gave me to remember her, and I told her, oh God, Tamara, I told you it would all be okay. For years I prayed my words were not a lie, that you had made it to the reef, that you were tending the ailing lattice roots. By the weaving, Tamara, how I prayed. Until I opened his machine. I saw Narayan through his shield. And even though the barrier kept me locked inside, I knew. I knew the lattice tree had died. Narayan can't survive without the tree. No one can be alive outside his shield. Standing in Atris's house, knowing that my wife and children were dead, I felt the fog roll toward me again. And as much as I wanted to give in to its numbness, I couldn't. I couldn't let Atris's wife find me standing there. Somehow I waded through the haze. I made my way to the study, found the book that would take me back to Jinanen. It was right where I'd left it, when I might not see it fall. I placed my hand on the panel, heard the door behind me opening, and then the study disappeared. She almost saw me. I know it. It was much too close this time. If the book hadn't been where I had left it. Next time I'll bring a book from one of his other ages with me, just in case it happens again. Yes, it's dangerous business sneaking about. Nearly got caught there, which would have prevented all of this. And on this side we have the number four. And more of this circuit-looking stuff. And number five. Not surprisingly. Wait, a giant cylinder with five things around it. Is that the ring with the dots from the diagram? Could be. Let's see what we need to do with that, though. I assume the goal is to connect all of it. And it seems that we've already gotten the top one right. At least it's right here. There might be more than one way to do it, so let's check if the other ones are correct as well. Well, these match up, so that seems to be okay. Yep. Here too. Well, I guess that means this one has to be right as well. So, well, since the top and bottom bits are stationary, let's do the bottom one. I can figure out how to hook that up. No, that's not right. We're missing one there. There. That looks okay for this one. Let's check the other ones again. Yep. And number three is okay as well. As is number two. And therefore it is pretty much impossible that number one isn't. Well, that leaves us with the middle section, which matches up this way. Nothing happened, though. Maybe this one isn't correct in all of them. And it's not. So let's try and match these up. This seems to be a slightly less common pattern. Hopefully when we get these right, the rest will follow. There we go! That did something. You can see sparks of electricity up there, leading towards these other cables. Cables on that side too. Kind of unclear. Maybe we can see that better from up here. Well, they are sort of connected to something. You can actually see the circuit structure inside as well. Seems this is some kind of electromagnet. Probably generating electricity, or at least transferring it from the rotation of the water wheel. And there are three terminals here, it seems. And on the diagram, the ring with five dots was connected to three further things. So, it does seem to make sense that this is the ring with dots from the diagram. Well, since that's a dead end, we have to go back. Which means we can verify that assertion. Stand on this stupid rotating thing again. Yeah, looks like we got power to the shield and the slinky. But although the dots lit up for the UFO itself is not lit up. So power's going that way, but it's not reaching it. I don't know if there's anything we can do about that, or if it's even important. Did this door open? It did not. I wasn't really expecting it to. This doesn't seem like an electronic lock. Although, speaking of electronic locks, we did see another door very similar to the one we just opened here on the island. So maybe that has power now and we can get inside. You can hear the water wheel from here, and you can also see it. And no, still not working. Doesn't seem like there's any power here. I wonder if that's because these two poles are not connected. As I pointed out earlier, this makes me wonder, either this thing is not on the diagram, therefore independently powered, or perhaps it is the UFO. Actually, come to think of it, if you look at it from a slightly larger distance, you can sort of see that the island with the tower on top forms the shape of the symbol. So that is the UFO. Or rather, not a UFO, it's an island. The symbol represents the island, so power is going this way, but not reaching it. And I suppose we're going to have to find a way to fix that. There's no obvious way of accomplishing that here. I guess that also means the tower was always this high, despite the fact that it looks like it has crumbled down, because it matches the symbol. I don't think the symbol updates dynamically. See now the cave is on the other side as well. Well, since there's nothing we can do with the island, and we did everything we could there, except for the locked door, which we can't open, so let's check this way. Going into the cavern. You know, Atrus, I have one word for you. Handrails. I mean, really, this is not an age for people with vertigo. What's that over there? Almost looks like the skeleton of some kind of animal, but it seems to be made of metal. Some kind of pipe being held up by this structure. Not sure what that's for. See here more of those poles connected by cables, so I guess that goes around the corner there, leading towards the gate, as we saw before. It looks like the cable goes towards this spherical thing. Check this path. Where is that going? That kind of resembles the diving board near the island. It seems like the cable goes past there and then over there. And this is an elevator. Huh. You know, I've seen my share of spiral staircases in my days as a Let's Player. But I do think this is the first time we've seen a spiral elevator. And there's also some more pages here. I see it all so clearly now. So clear without the fog to sweep it away. How the young men in the village don't want to listen to the elders. How they stand together at the back of the room, a growing knot of anger twisting inside them. Why should we abide by your rules, old men? They scream. You have no life inside you left to live. You gave it up decades ago to the tree. Tamara wants to take the children home. She doesn't like the way the tempers are rising. Do something, Savidro, she whispers. Tell them to stop shouting and make them listen. Tell them! What, my love? Tell them what? That their young lives do not belong to them alone? That our people are meant to be slaves to our world? Sirius and Akinar can see the confusion they're creating. I catch them looking at faces, measuring which men are most dissatisfied. Later they will approach these men in secret. They will urge the malcontents to boycott our rituals. They will prey on their youth and dissatisfaction. And the young men will begin forming gangs. They will throw off our traditions, rise against the elders, and follow the brothers. Riots will start. The tree will be neglected. Oh, Tamara, it's all so obvious now. But why couldn't I see it at the time? Every lie the brothers told, every whisper made to put themselves in power. When our world started collapsing around us, why didn't I see how Sirius and Akinar didn't care? They never believed the truth behind our traditions. They never understood the work we had to do. They only knew the time had come to leave. And when they did, they left their linking book behind, knowing I would use it to chase after them. They lured me to this world, tied me up, and left me to die here. Because I didn't stop them when I should have. Yeah, Savidro, hindsight. I guess these are the events leading up to the second painting that we saw in Amateria. Civil War on Orion. Which Sirius and Akinar were responsible for. So I can certainly see why Savidro is doing what he's doing. Even if I don't agree with it. So the cable goes into that spherical thing. And there's a lever. Well, what do you know? It's not actually spherical, it's hemispherical. And it's some kind of door. It looks like the cable actually goes through the door to whatever it is that's behind there. Couldn't really see what it is that's behind there, though. That pipe is attached to it, though. Must have something to do with it. It looks like the path we were on before leads to the other side of that door, so we'll be able to see what is there in the next video.